Hello students, how are you all? I hope that you are fit and fine at your home. Today we are going to deal with the geography subject of 6th standard. First chapter, the earth and gratitude. Today we are going to study the remaining part of this chapter. Before that we have studied the imaginary lines, angular distance, parallels of latitude and the term equator, and at the last we have learned that is the angular measurement of earth. Okay student, yes, as well as we have studied the figure number 1.9. Okay, the figure number 1.9 is very important to understand the meridians of longitude. So today we are going to learn the meridians of longitude. Okay, what are these longitudes actually on the globe? Okay student, so see here on the whiteboard I have drawn a rough diagram of the sphere. Okay, you can see the sphere here. Okay, as we have done one activity, that is figure number 1.9. in figure number 1.9 we have seen that this is the A point, B I see this activity we have done already. Okay, and it has 0 degree. Okay, then see yes, C was 85 degree, okay, yes, and B was 75 degree, okay. This activity we have done already, okay, 1.9 figure, center is M here, okay. So here, angle B, angle A, angle C formed angle here in center, okay. AMB is 75 degree. AMC is 85 degree. Okay, and we have drawn a line which passes through A and which joins A and passes through M center. Okay, M center. This is called as prime meridian. Okay, and in the same way we can draw a semicircle on these points. For example, see, I will draw roughly. See, roughly I have drawn a semicircle, okay. So here, for example, this is 85 degree semicircle. This is drawn on 0 degree, okay. In the same way, we can draw from here. Okay, in this way, we can draw the semicircles at the particular interval of degree. For example, it is 0, so it can... It is, if it is 0, then it will be 10 degree, 20 degree, okay, then 30 degree, then 40 degree, then, okay, 50 degree, in this way. And we can draw the semicircles passing through these degrees, passing through these degrees. For example, one more I will show you. I am drawing very roughly because I don't have any equipment to draw it. Then we will draw this one. One more I will show you. Are you getting? We can draw the semicircles passing through a particular degree. Okay student, a particular degree. As we know, this is 0 degree, so it will increase to the east side. This is east. We know this is east. This is waist. And as we know, it is north and it is south. So the degree will increase, the value of the this longitude will increase toward the east side. 0 to 90 and opposite side 90. 90 plus 90, how many? 90 plus 90 degree means 180 degree. So this hemisphere, this half hemisphere is of 180 degree. Okay, student? So in this way, we can draw the semicircles. These semicircles are called as meridians of longitude. Okay, student, what do we call it as? This is called as meridians of longitude. Meridians of longitude. These are called as meridians of longitude. In the same way, we can draw on the west side also after a particular interval of degrees. Okay, after a particular interval of degrees. Okay, if it is 0, then 10, it will be 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, like this. Okay, these semicircles help us to identify the actual location on the surface of Earth. Okay, student, so these are meridians of longitude. We know this is the equator. This is the largest equator on the Earth. Okay. Okay, student. And this is called as latitude, parallels of latitude. This is called as parallels of latitudes. The adjacent distance between the parallels is equal one till the end of the Earth, till the end of the hemisphere. Okay. The distance is equal one. Okay. Just the ellipses go on decreasing. But the distance is same one. The distance is 101 kilometer. Okay. 101 kilometer. Okay, student. Now see, the distance between the two adjacent longitude is same on the equator only. On the equator. Okay. And poles. It is going on decreasing. See, here and here it goes on what? Decreasing. It is going on decreasing. Smaller and smaller. Okay. Yes, like this. 111 kilometer. Okay, student. Yes, have you understood now? Yes. Now, again, one more important thing I would like to tell you. This line which passes through the center, okay, it has the value of 0 degree. What? 0 degree. And this is called as a prime meridian. This is called as prime meridian. That help us to form the angles. Okay. For example, here angle is formed here. In this way. So this center that we called it as prime meridian help to form the angles. Okay. And so that we can identify the location on the surface of Earth. Okay. For example, we have learned that 30 degree. On 30 degree Cairo in Africa. Okay. This line or prime meridian divides this sphere into two parts. This is called as Eastern Hemisphere. Okay. And this is called as Western Hemisphere. As we learn, Northern Hemisphere, Southern Hemisphere, in the same way, this prime meridian divides the sphere into two parts, that is Eastern Hemisphere and Western Hemisphere. As we learn that if you want to locate a location in northern hemisphere, that we have to mention the northern hemisphere. For example, 30 degree north. Okay, 30 degree south. So we are mentioning here the hemisphere. In the same way, here also we have to mention the hemisphere. For example, 30 degree east. Okay, 30 degree west. In this way, roughly I have drawn the diagram and I have tried to make you understand what is longitude. These lines are called as longitudes, and the horizontal semicircles are called as parallels of latitude. Okay, and this center, the line which passes through the center, is called as prime meridian, and it has 0 degree value. The value increases towards the east side. Okay, and one hemisphere is of 180 degree. This 180 degree and this side 180 degree, how much? 360 degree. We know the globe has 360 degree value. Okay, 360 degree value. The adjacent distance between the two longitudes is similar on the equatorial plane only, and it goes on decreasing towards the poles. Okay, student, have you understood? Yes? Anything is left? Yeah? Have you understood? Yes, very good. So, today what we have learned? The prime meridian, meridians of longitude, the degrees can be mentioned. 10 degree east, 20 degree east, 30 degree east. In the same way, this side, 10 degree west, 20 degree west, 30 degree west. In this way, we can mention the hemisphere while mentioning the what values. Okay, student, have you understood? See, if you want to locate the location of a place, then it is very difficult because it is 111 kilometer it is. So, we have to divide this into, for example, so it is very important to locate. So, how to locate? Because, see, the distance between the two adjacent longitude is 111 kilometer. So, we have to divide it into the smaller and smaller. So, degrees should be divided into smaller units. For example, degrees divided into minutes, and minutes into seconds. Okay, degrees, minutes and seconds. 1 degree is divided into 60 minutes and 1 minute is divided into 60 seconds. And see, student, here how to mention the degree? We know that we mention the degree in this way. Okay, minute can be labeled like this and seconds like this. Okay, student, for example, 30 degree, okay, and 8 seconds. So in this way we can mention the values. Okay, student, have you understood now? Very good. Yes, student, now have you understood longitudes, okay, and latitudes? Okay, yes. Now, as we have seen that 181 parallels of latitude can be drawn on a globe. How many? 181. 90 on the northern side and 90 on the southern side. Then, in the same way, how many longitudes can be drawn on the globe? Okay? Yes, so let's see. So, I will write here. We know the globe is of 360 degree. We know that the globe is of 360 degree. We have 0 degree at the prime meridian. So, this is 0 degree prime meridian. In short, I will write 0 degree prime meridian. And just now I told you the globe has 360 degree. Okay, Then on the eastern side, I told you 180 meridians we can draw. 180 meridians. 180 meridians. Okay. 180 degree meridians we can draw. From 1 degree to 179 degree. Okay. When we will include prime meridian into this, it will be 180. Okay. It will be 180. Okay, student. Have you understood? So, on the eastern side, on the eastern hemisphere, we can draw how many meridians? 180 meridians we can draw on eastern side. Okay, eastern side. Okay, student, have you got now? In the same way, we can draw 180 meridians on the western hemisphere. Okay, student, see, 0 degree prime meridian. 0 degree prime meridian and 180 meridian we can draw here. 180 meridians we can draw here. From 1 degree to 179 degree. Okay. When we include this into this, this can be counted as a 1 meridian. Okay. That is prime meridian. Okay. So we will include that in into this. So, it will be 180 degree. Yes? Understood, student? Now, see. 180 and 180. 180 meridians on the eastern hemisphere and 180 on the western hemisphere. So, 180, 180. How much? Yes. 180 plus 180 is equal to 360 degree. Okay, student, have you understood now how many meridians we can draw on eastern hemisphere as well as on the western hemisphere? Okay, have you understood? Very good. Okay, students, now have you understood the meridians of longitude? Yes. Do you like the activity? Very good. If you have liked this video, like it. Comment below the video and do not forget to share it and subscribe it. Okay, student, and be connected for more such important educational videos. Okay, thank you.